Let's begin with chapter number 8 from your economics book of grade 12, and the name of the chapter is cost and revenue analysis. In this chapter we shall study how cost varies with variations in output. So basic concept of cost of output, the term cost has a wide variety of meaning. So first we'll try to understand what is the meaning of money cost. Ordinarily the concept of cost of production is used in the sense of money cost. Money cost refers to money expenses which a firm has to incur in purchasing or hiring the factor services. If you remember in the previous chapters, we have understood what are the factor services. That means like you can say paying wages to the laborers, because they are giving their service to the factory, okay, for the production purpose. So we have to pay them the wages. So this kind of expenses which is borne by the firm in order to do the production, either they are purchasing or they are hiring these factor services. Okay, these are called, we can say about the rent also. Okay, if they are buying the machines, those expenses also are being calculated. So money which is spent over the factors. Okay, these are called the money cost. Next, accounting books of a firm record these actual money expenses made by the firm on the factors of production as the cost of production. Okay, so whatever money is spent, that is being accounted, and those are being said as the accounting cost or the business cost. Okay, money payments made by the firms to the owners of various factor services in purchasing and hiring the factor services required in the production of a commodity is known as explicit cost. Once again, money payments made by the firms to the owners of various factor services in purchasing or hiring the factor services required in the production of a commodity is known as explicit cost. So whatever the payment is being paid to the owners, from the owner side they are saying it is the explicit cost. Next, what is economic cost? Economic cost, we can say, is considered in three components. One is money cost, explicit cost, implicit cost, and normal profit. So we have understood what is money cost, explicit cost. Now we'll try to understand what is implicit cost. Implicit cost refers to the impute or estimate value. We are just estimating the value of input owned by the firm and used by it in its own production unit. Suppose somebody is making a factory and he himself has a piece of land. So he is not buying, neither he is taking the land in rent. Okay, so he is using his own factor of production here. So we have to estimate the value of that piece of land also. That estimation is called implicit cost. But he is not paying anybody, because he himself is using it, because he is the owner of that piece of land. Okay, so then also we have to calculate what is the price of that piece of land, and that will be considered as implicit cost. Normal profit. Normal profit is defined as the minimum payment which a producer must get. Okay, which a producer must get in order to induce him to undertake the risk involved in production. So normal profit is the minimum supply price of the entrepreneurial services. So the way they are bearing the risk, okay, the risk bearing factor, they are investing so much and they are having the risk bearing factor. So whatever they are earning, that is their minimum profit, the normal profit, because they are investing so much and at the end of the day it is going to be a fruitful one or it's going to be totally waste. So the return is their normal profit. Now we can define what is economic cost. Economic cost is the sum total of both explicit and implicit cost, including normal profit. So all these three things are needed to form the economic cost. So economic cost is equal to explicit cost plus implicit cost and including the normal profit. Opportunity cost. Okay, what is opportunity cost? From the term itself you can understand opportunity. The opportunity cost of production any good is the next best alternative good that is given up to produce this good. That means here they are trying to explain us, in order to produce some other good, how much you are sacrificing the good you are making now. Okay, here the cost of production of particular quantity of a commodity is measured in terms of the quantity of other commodity that could have been obtained instead. The opportunity cost arises because of the scarcity of resources and the fact that resources have alternative uses. Suppose somebody is given option that either you can make 1 meter of cloth or 20 loaves of bread. So we can say that the opportunity cost is 1 meter cloth cost is equal to 20 loaves of bread. Okay, so whatever the raw material the person is having, with that either he could produce the commodity A or he can go for commodity B. It's up to him. What is the alternative? Okay, that is the opportunity cost. So if he would not produce commodity A, he would have gone for commodity B. In terms of the alternation, we are calculating the opportunity cost. What was the next best opportunity? If he would have not produced commodity A, he could produce commodity B with the same amount of investment. Next is a real cost. Real cost refers to the efforts of sacrifices made by the owners of factors to produce of production used in the production of a commodity. Means what are the sacrifices they are doing? Suppose a labor is providing his physical and the mental efforts. Okay, the owner is giving away his accumulated capital. So these are the sacrifices they are doing. This is the real cost. Okay, private and social cost. Private cost refers to the cost of production incurred by an individual firm in the production of commodity. So it is talking about an individual firm. Okay, and social cost, on the other hand, refers to the cost that the society has to bear on account of the production of the commodity. So what kind of cost the society is going to bear, okay, that is called the social cost. What? Like, it is a sum total of the cost incurred by the producers of goods and services, that is the private cost, and the cost experienced by those who have suffered because of the production. So in other words, we can say social cost is equal to private cost plus external cost. What is this external cost? External cost is a cost that is not borne by the firm, but it incurred by other members of the society or the entire society. Like, for example, if a factory have been built up, where will the waste materials go? They will easily dump it in the open ground, or maybe in anywhere in the river or anywhere they will dump it. Right, so who is going to bear this? The farm is not sitting back with the waste materials. The society is getting affected by it. So they are saying social cost means private cost plus the external cost is the social cost. Okay. Next is behavior of cost in the short run. First of all, correspondence to the short run and long run production functions. There are two types of cost functions. Short run cost function and the long run cost function. First, we are going to discuss with the short run cost function. Fixed cost and variable cost. We are familiar with both the terms. Fixed cost means it is not going to change, and variable cost means it is going to be varying from time to time. It is going to change. So factor of production in the short run are classified into two categories, fixed factors and variable factors. Okay, fixed factors of such as capital, equipments, factory buildings, management, etc. are the factors of quantity of which can neither be increased nor decreased in the short run. Fixed inputs they are talking about here. Okay, variable factors on the other hand are those factors the supply of which can be easily changed by any desired quantity in the short run. Raw materials and labor are the examples of variable factors. Corresponding to fixed factors and variable factors, economic cost is classified into two categories, namely fixed cost and variable cost. Here we are coming across fixed cost and variable cost. So fixed cost is the cost which is incurred on fixed factors. Whenever we are applying or hiring the fixed factors, we are giving them the fixed cost. The money we are spending is the fixed cost. Okay, like for example, fixed cost consists of the salary of the permanent staff, interest of the borrowed economy. So whenever we are hiring or applying the fixed factors, for the fixed factors we cannot change the cost. So fixed cost is there permanently, fixed is there. And variable cost is that cost which is incurred on variable factors. Like we can increase the labor, decrease the labor. As we are increasing the casual labors, we are paying them. Tomorrow we can replace them. Raw materials, we are buying now. Raw materials, if you buy after 10 days, it might get increased, it might get decreased. Okay, so the variable cost, for the variable cost is the cost which we are paying in order to hire or to buy the variable factors. The short run total cost of production is the sum total of fixed cost and variable cost. So we have to sum it. That means we have to add fixed cost and variable cost of the short run to get the production cost. So in order to get short run total cost of production, in short run, the total cost of production is equal to fixed cost plus variable cost. We can consider cost in terms of total cost, average cost and marginal cost. Okay, what is total cost curves we are going to discuss here? Total cost curves. Total cost refers to total obligations incurred by the firm in producing any given quantity of the output. So here in short we can say whatever the money is spent in the short run, whatever the money is spent for the production is the total cost. Okay, it is the sum total of all expenditure incurred in production or given producing a given quantity of output. So in short run total cost, this total cost is getting divided into two parts. One is total fixed cost and the other is total variable cost. Total fixed cost means total fixed cost refers to the total cost incurred by the firm on using all the fixed factors. Very simple. So total cost is getting divided into two categories. One is the total fixed cost, which is we are paying the fixed factors, that is the total fixed cost. And total variable cost is the amount we are paying to the variable factors, that is the total variable cost. So total cost, total fixed cost is also known as unavoidable cost, or we can say supplementary cost or overhead cost. And total variable cost, we often say it as avoidable cost or prime cost, direct cost. Okay, so let us sum it up. What is total cost? Here we can say total cost is the cost incurred on all types of inputs, okay, fixed as well as the variable inputs, incurred in producing a given amount of output. So TC is equal to TFC plus TVC. Okay, let us now understand it in a tabular format. You can see what is the output from 0 to 6. You can see the output 0 to 6. within this 0 to 6 output, we can see that the total fixed cost is same from the moment it have started till the moment it have shut down. Maybe the output is 0 or the output is highest point is 6. You can see that the total fixed cost is fixed. It's not changing. It's 120 only. But total variable cost is changing. Total variable cost is increasing in a decreasing rate, and then it is increasing at an increasing rate from the fourth unit. Right? From the fourth unit, we can see that it is increasing in an increasing rate. Until the third one, we can see it is increasing, but in a decreasing rate. And what is total cost? You can see the column number 4, it is just the sum total of TFC plus TVC. Yes, 120 plus 40, we are getting 160. You can see 120 plus 76, we are getting 196. Right? So the curve also we need to analyze here. You can see that the total, that is total fixed cost, TFC, is continuously the same. So let us come to the next page. You can see the diagram given here. Right? TFC is fixed to, it's parallel to the x-axis, and we can see it is just lying straight. Right? So it is not changing. And we can see that TVC is first from the origin, it is 0. From the origin, it is 0, and slowly, gradually, it is increasing till point OQ. You see, below OQ, as it is intersecting and going up, the line is going up, TVC, follow TVC. As it is intersecting and going up, you can see it is increasing in an increasing rate. Before that also, it was increasing, but it was increasing in a decreasing rate. But as it have intersected the TFC curve, it have started increasing in an increasing rate. Okay, and TFC is just the sum total, so the difference will remain the same. Okay, the gap, the difference will remain the same. So we can say TC curve, so total cost is the sum of total fixed cost and total variable cost. Hopefully you understood till this much. Thank you.